scanning for audio.
Welcome to a Tin Dog podcast. Published on the 3rd of November this year, three books available from BBC Books. They are hardback and they are what you'll be wanting in your stocking at Christmas. These books have been unavailable for a very, very long time. In the great and glorious days before Target novelisations were the only way we could experience old Doctor Who, some people had tried Doctor Who books in the past. Three of the earliest, if not the earliest, were The Crusaders, Doctor Who and the Daleks, and of course Doctor Who and the Zabi. Now of course we know that they're not quite the stories that we know. But then again, from these storylines, this isn't quite the stories that we know either. Now we all know the Crusaders and the fact that the Crusaders doesn't really exist anymore in any true format. Yes, there's a couple of episodes dotted here and there, and audio-wise you can experience it. But if you want something different, then David Whittaker's novel, with its gloriously retro title, with its gloriously retro cover, well, that's going to distract you for most of Christmas Day. This is the sort of thing you'll be getting in your stocking, and you're very pleased and you'll thank everyone. And then you'll go, could everyone just leave me alone for a couple of hours while I read this? All three of them are like that, to be honest. You've got Richard the Lionheart, Saladin and the Saracens. You've got Barbara captured. You've got all sorts of actual excitement. And you know what? Although these may have been originally written for children, they don't feel like it at all. They are rollicking adventures. And yes, the idea of, well, Ian coming across the TARDIS on the common don't ring as true as it might and feel a little bit more like the movie. Well, you can forgive it, can't you? These things are just wonderful slices of the past. So if you want your hands on something you've not been able to get your hands on for a long time, then why not experience these? It's a brave decision to go for Doctor Who and the Daleks and not have a picture of a Dalek on the front of the book, but that's because they are reprints, facsimile editions, and they feel glorious in your hands. Yes, you can buy them as e-books, but it just won't feel the same. They're £9.99 each and are utterly perfect. And of course, if ever you've watched The Web Planet, well, you might want to watch it with slightly better effects, and you can get those inside your own head for free. So why not stare at some dead tree for a couple of hours and hallucinate, or as it's known in the trade, read, and then experience something marvellous. All three of these books came out on the 3rd of November and are available in any bookshop. And I, for one, am very grateful for them coming out. So in a year without Doctor Who, we've got a surprisingly large amount of Doctor Who. So until next time, be seeing you. That was the Doctor Who Tin Dog podcast, available on iTunes, YouTube, Twitter, RSS, Vimeo, and across the internet. Doctor Who and its associated properties are all copyright and trademark of the BBC. No infringement is intended. Why not become a supporter by visiting patreon.com/tindog? Contact the show on tin-dog@hotmail.co.uk. The Tin Dog podcast is a founder member of the Doctor Who Podcast Alliance.